Took care of the logistics of everything, and I'm here with Richard O'Shaughnessy, bringing you tonight's game. We do apologize for the delay, as the leadership has a little bit of trouble getting here.
Good rebound by Bray. Oh, good save, good hustle by Zach.
What do we have for scoring so far? I saw Greg get a three.
Yeah, he hit a nice three off the assist from Shane. It's a good way to start the game.
Definitely. So you show up an hour late and bring six guys.
Yeah. Not sure how that happened, but either way, it should be a good game to help make up for it.
We can hope. Be a good game for South Kent. You got some guys coming back from injury.
Yeah, Reggie,
Nolan.
Which is two good forces in the middle of the paint, which we need.
It's all of South Kent size and those two guys right there. It's kind of funny seeing an empty bench on the other side. Of course, Dusan Perovic probably out for the season with that ankle sprain.
Yeah, he's having a hard time with that, and I know he's upset that he can't play. But you can't risk that.
Right.
When you got an ankle injury, you can't mess around with that. So.
Hey, Fox. He's always remember that he's got next year too.
Yep, and he's a good player, a star player. You can see him, so he's nothing to worry about as long as he keeps playing.
Schools here tonight. I saw Springfield College, good D3 program.
Yeah.
Here to look at Brayton tonight.
Yeah?
Yep. That's what I was talking to him before the game.
Yeah, good for these guys. You know, they come out, they play hard every game. And it really pays off when you get it.
Definitely.
You know, no matter what college it is, it always feels good to have a coach recognize you like that.
You say he could be a good player at that level. I agree.
Yeah, he's a good shot. He's quick. So. There's a two-pointer.
Good hook there for Malik Miles. Just under 16 minutes to go in the first half. So this game ended up being prime time.
Yeah.
There's not to go unnoticed, Richard O'Shaughnessy on the varsity basketball program here at South Kent. They're a big game tomorrow.
Yep, against Chase at their court, battling for the home court and the playoffs, which is a big advantage.
Huge.
So it's a big game for us. We'll play as hard as we can.
As Reggie gets fouled, and that foul is on once he turns around.
He's still not sure.
Looks like number 11, that's Deshaun Lumpkin.
Three by Brayton, just barely off. South Kent started off well, but the last couple of shots just haven't gone in.
one thing I've noticed in my first month and a half here, they tend to get off to slow starts.
Yeah. Yeah, we tend to have that problem too. It's kind of just it's like a good play by Reggie there. Just a mental thing.
Yeah.
When you have the confidence, it's a good feeling when you do, when you start off well.
Right. Open up, drain a few shots, and get some confidence going. Here's this foul, and that was number 34, Colin Nelson, picking up the foul. Leadership Prep has got to hope nobody fouls out today.
Yeah, the six players in the game. These are going to get real tired real fast. I've been in this situation before. Long dunk by Shane. Good steal, but got to finish that off. Reggie looks to make the power move.
Good ball movement here. Everybody touching the ball.
Said coming off that nail-biting 35-point game there. What a game from him. Notre Dame.
Mr. Larson just checking in on us on his phone. He goes, looks great, everything's good. I'm gonna turn my phone down and start focusing on driving.
Oh, that Mr. Larson.
He's drove Newark tonight, coming back. And then if this game keeps up, he'll be here before the end of it.
Thanks to that hour delay.
Right. So if you got tired of watching the celebrity basketball game, tune into some South Kent prep basketball. Go to highschoolcube.com, search South Kent, or you can click on the AMG link on South Kent School's website, southkentschool.org. Back to the play here.
Rebound again. Make a lot of hustle plays out there.
A real good four man, I think.
Yep.
Jamal Richards there picking up 2 points.
That's a nice assist.
Just saw Duncan now with the raindrop. Do you know if Reggie's gotten any looks yet?
That I'm not sure about. And their threes just don't seem to be falling yet. But that'll change.
Ooh, number 10, that's Darnell Tyson with the three. That was a deep three, too. A lot of contact there.
Yep. Good rebound, though. Just gotta polish that off.
Oh, good pass.
And good finish.
He also did well enough to step on top of Malik Miles. I don't know how many rebounds are there. He just got there.
I'd say about four. Ooh. Three by Nolan, one by Reg.
Sounds good. And then Kamal Richards finishes off the bucket. And Nolan with a nice pass.
Zach Brown checks in for Reggie.
And Reggie might have picked up quick two fouls. That's one thing, they always pick on the big man.
Yeah.
The fouls.
Yeah, I've been a big man before for a lot of my career, as strange as that looks. And sometimes it's just hard to stay out of foul trouble. You know, you got a lot of point guards in there, be real quick, and you got nothing to do. Hit them sometimes.
Right. Like Miles getting that board right there. a stat book today. He's got a block, an assist, a couple rebounds.
And South Kent's just coming out to a pretty fast start, which is good. You know, these fast starts, like I said, builds confidence, and they can roll you for the rest of the game. You know?
And if you get a big enough lead early, all you gotta do is go block them, of course.
Yeah. I didn't check.
Oh my goodness.
Oh no, that's my basket. And there's a dunk by Shane Rector.
So you show up late tomorrow, Jim?
And they said, that's my basket too.
You show up late tomorrow, Jim, I'll show you not to be late again. You got a rainbow of shoes on the court. I see blue, yellow.
Yeah, that seems to be a green thing in the NBA now with basketball. These bright colored shoes. I don't own a pair myself, but whatever, you know, whatever suits you.
Good move there. Number 24, Charles Reese. Nolan Long picks up a foul.
Here comes in number one, Robert Taylor, for Shane Rector. Subbing in as the point guard, I assume.
Good chance for RJ to get some more playing time, get some more tape sent out to the top schools.
Yeah, he's been working hard this year, that's for sure. I certainly enjoyed playing alongside him last 3 years. Good for him moving up.
Definitely. Not very often you can see a guy move up through the ranks of varsity prep.
Yeah. Real well, so proud of him.
And a local kid too.
Yeah, Wingdale, New York. So not very far away.
About, what, 10-15 minute drive, not even?
Yeah, you always get a lot of kids, the prep team especially, you know, we got some from California, further up, New York, you know, New Jersey.
City kids.
Yeah. So it's good to have some local blood in there.
We got New Jersey, Zach Brown from Texas, Paul Richards from Pennsylvania, Shane Rector from the Bronx, Buffalo, Seattle, California, Montenegro, Tucson, coming from all corners of the world here.
Right, not even, you know, not even far in the United States, but other countries as well. That's pretty remarkable.
And he nails it. Good for RJ. Huge. And you got a great supporting cast here, too. We got a good fan base on for tonight.
Oh, yeah. Another rejection by Nolan.
It's three.
And the alley-oop to Zach Brown.
Is that from RJ?
That was from Maul. Having trouble keeping score here.
Ooh, this
just shows a fast pace scoring by South Kent.
Right. Duncan hits the three there. So I got at least four for Reggie, at least six for Kamal. Shane's got four. And Zach Brown's got four, RJ's got three. And Nolan's got at least three blocks and three rebounds.
Nolan being the force out there. Defense leads into offense, so it's really, really quite a boost to have a good defender out there.
This one, if South Kent can do one thing, if they can play defense, they'll have a shot. I mean, you can say that for almost any team, but that's one thing that South Kent's had a little bit of trouble with, is defense.
But it just bounces out.
The refs will let them play a little bit tonight. Good moves there, he's good finish. Ooh, AJ not looking for that.
I gotta pay attention on the court there.
Good defense there by leadership.
Yeah. backs out.
Close to the back.
Yeah, very close.
Fast break points here. Oh, good bad passing.
And what I'm liking about this this leadership prep is that even though they're losing, they're really driving the ball and they're really being fast paced. And that's what you need to do. You need to really hustle and you need to really drive it. You can't settle for outside shots.
Right.
Nice. If you're gonna try to come back, if you're hitting threes, you're hitting threes. But you know, you need to really work the other team.
Right.
And they need to work South Kent down. But South Kent's not backing down.
Definitely not. That's a good job by the leadership coach to cycle through his guys. So he's only got six to make sure not all of them are getting tired at the same time.
Yeah, I got to keep fresh legs out there.
And I noticed they're also not a very big team.
No, they don't have a lot of size. So they won't be able to necessarily get into the lane as much as Nolan has proven, but they still need to try.
And as good as the ball movement is early on, I would say try not to get too carried away with it. Because if it's too easy, it's probably a reason.
Yeah. You need to be careful with your passes too.
Make sure you run the same sets on offense. Don't change your game because of the competition.
It's Greg Davis and Reggie check-in.
You know what I can't wait for? Okay, I keep looking at Nolan. I see a 90 mile an hour fastball coming off his hand.
Yeah. Yes.
Can't wait to see that in the springtime. For those of you maybe first timers to AMG, we've mentioned it before on the air. The backcourt, Nolan got drafted by the Giants, but his love for basketball kept him in school, and he wants to go play basketball and do a double sport at a college.
That's pretty impressive. You know, it's not every day you get somebody who can, you know, shoot a basketball and pitch baseball. You know, who's
right.
6'9".
Like going straight downhill like Randy Johnson.
Yeah. So very talented.
Let's see here. Oh, luckily going to the line, but he wasn't shooting. Looking to pass. You can see his shoes from outer space. What sport do you do in the spring?
For the past couple of years, I've been rowing.
Rowing crew.
Yep, which is quite a different sport.
Yeah.
To admit.
And it's no walk at the park either, so I
thought. Oh, no. When you get out there and row, you know, 1,500 meters, it's 7 minutes in person, you know, which is why I'm always glad to get back to basketball. Not that it's my favorite sport, it's my love, you know, but
yeah,
crew is just a different mindset, you know. Good take by RJ as he passes the back around.
Looking at what might be a stat night tonight.
Yeah.
We might not record all the steals and assists and blocks and rebounds here, but they're there, folks. Good move there.
And if you're in leadership's position right now, South Kent is clearly the best group of
agents. They're bigger and they're playing like it.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's good for South Kent. But if you're leadership, you need to know that you just can't give up. You just keep playing. Just keep driving.
Right.
Because it can only get worse if you're going to give up.
It's a test of character.
Yeah.
happened to their sixth player. I did see somebody come off with a little hobbled ankle. Maybe what happened to him. Or maybe he had to go to the bathroom. There he is. He's back. Or a bathroom break. Malik Miles picks up a foul. I got 1-1 already, so I missed 4 fouls.
Yeah. 1-1 is not what you want to get in a game that you are not winning.
Trailing by 21 with 41-20 with about 4:21 left in the first half. To give recognition to everyone helping out tonight, we got Renshu. We got Renshu in the truck. We got Jinway on camera. We got Richard O'Shaughnessy with the helping me here with the commentary, and we got Brian Farrell doing the scoreboard. So we give thanks to everybody. So with a rather later than expected evening. South Kent on the season. They've been hitting their free throws tonight, but on the season, as Reese picks up a foul. On the season, South Kent's about 60% from the line.
And that's dangerous because that means you could either make it, but there's also a big chance you can miss it. And as in games like the last game they had against Notre Dame, which is 108-106 in overtime, you know, there were a couple foul shots. I watched that game that could have won it.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's true, you do live and die by the free throw line in most games.
Let's see if I had, did I say that correctly? Yeah, 60% from the line.
So yes, foul shots, very important. Good take by AJ, looking to drive it, passes out to Greg at the three-point line there. Just misses it. Good rebound by Reggie, though, as he puts it back up. Dude, does so well.
Reggie's now got at least 8. We got everything organized at halftime as well. Ooh. Reggie picks up the foul there.
10. Looked a little shaken up as he hit the ground. But he hurt his arm a little bit. That was 1-2 on a team with only 6 players.
Yeah, right. So. Number 10 seems to be their deep threat, too, as he had a couple deep threes already.
Good defense by Robert Taylor. I'm sure he's excited to be playing this game right now.
Oh, definitely.
Good steal. Good defense.
Anytime you want to make a chance, anytime your coach gives you a shot.
Oh, you gotta go play your hardest half down. That's what he's doing.
Absolutely.
Pops a three. Good rebound by RJ.
And then once you get to this point in the game, it's kind of all you can expect. Run up and take a pull-up jumper. Because as we've seen with Reggie and Nolan showing their size, you're not going to get inside very much.
Yeah. Especially with this team, got being especially tall. That call I'm not too sure about, but that's okay.
And his player's going over, asking politely, what did I do wrong? And the refs explained to him, so.
Malik Miles expressing his opinion.
Respectfully disagreeing with the official.
And you gotta be careful of that, but it's always good, you know, just to show some emotion.
Right. Just ask them what you're doing wrong.
Yeah.
Not just saying. You know, we were talking about the free throws before, and in the game against New Hampton that they won at home, they shot 16 of 33 from the line, which is under 50%, and they almost shot themselves out of that game.
Which is, yeah, not good.
In the last couple games, they've been doing a little better against St. Thomas More, they shot 23 of 33, so 70%, a little better. And last game, they were 12 of 17 to 71%.
And there's nothing you can do to get better at free throws but practice free throws.
Sit in the gym, shoot a couple hundred free throws.
Yeah, you got to. Every single day, you can't miss a day.
No.
And I know it's just got to be so frustrating for a coach. You know, even as a player, I get incredibly frustrated when I miss free throws.
Right.
So with the game on the line and your team's missing free throws as a coach, it's got to be hard to take down.
But it was after one of your, it was a giveaway there by Taylor. But it's good job hustling back and not giving them the easy 2 points.
Yeah, if you're going to get a turnover or you're going to make a mistake on offense, you got to hustle back and make it up on defense. That's the most important thing.
So that's what we call a good foul.
Yeah.
Right, after one of your games, I saw you guys missing free throws. Now, the prep game to follow, they were missing free throws, just as Nelson does here. I sat in the gym for a couple hours shooting free throws. I'm like, how hard is this? How hard is this?
Yep, and I remember playing, Harvey?
Harvey, yeah. The buzzer beater game.
Yep.
That you'd probably like to forget about.
Oh, man. Those kinds of games, you just kind of go back to the bench and you kind of just wonder
what happened.
What happened? And, everybody was to blame in that game. You know, we weren't shooting well. We really missed our free throws. I know I missed two clutch free throws in the end. And just, that's something I can't. Right. You know, I just got to get back to the court and practice. So Rob gets a nice rebound. Look at him pass it. Pass it to Zach. Good pass.
Good pass.
Just missed the floor. So RJ's really hustling out there right now. Brayton with the good defense. Passes it up court and finishes the break. AJ Edwards.
AJ, Yale commit.
Yeah.
Good to get some Ivy prospects coming through the South Kent. Ooh, nice block by Brown. Oh, good board there by RJ.
There you go.
Is that AJ again at the finish?
Yep. AJ, an exceptional three-point shooter, moving inside this game. Of course, if they're letting you move inside, why not? And it seems that this leadership prep is starting to get winded.
Yeah.
Right now. And, only 50 seconds left in the half. And I'm sure they're looking for a water break. As you can see, they're just shooting up threes.
Just like AJ Edwards.
Yeah.
He's got about 11 points tonight.
He's got some rampage right now. Zach Brown takes it easily, lays it up.
Coast to coast, he's got about 10 now. Zach Brown gonna be around for another year. Bad giveaway there. Here's a chance. NBA range. Oh, he makes it rain at the buzzer. Darnell Tyson showing range early. Or showing for the first half, he's their deep threat. So if I was a college looking at a player, I'd look at maybe Darnell Tyson for some range.
Yeah, he certainly got a bomb out there.
But with that comes the end of the first half. The score is South Kent 55, Leadership Prep 26. Thank you. All right, and welcome back. We had a quick halftime, so running around now. I'm Anthony Picardi. And we're getting underway here. I guess they're trying to speed this up as much as they can to get all the folks home as Malik Miles shoots up a three ball and misses. Braden Madrigal down the other end. He also misses a deep three, and rebound goes to Lumpkin. Ooh, good hustle there by both players. But their official says it's off white. So, a little thrown off by the quick halftime.
Hey guys, sorry about that. I'm back now. Shorter halftime than I anticipated.
So did I. I heard the buzzer. I saw the guys coming down. I'm like, oh wow.
That's okay. Momentum may not be lost. Good move by Shane.
You know, one thing I was thinking of, I was going to say, but I want to wait for you to say it, but make sure you don't get injured in a game like this.
Yeah.
To blow out. I mean, the last thing you want is an injury.
Yeah, you know, especially during the end of the season, if you want to get to the playoffs.
Right.
You know, you want to get higher up, you got to be careful about that.
And getting to the playoffs, as you mentioned, you get the upcoming schedule. We got Bridgeton on Sunday at home, Marianapolis at home next Wednesday, NIA Prep at home next Friday, and then we get the NEPSAC playoffs that are going to be held at Endicott College. So most likely AMG will be on the road. And Richard, I'm going to have you take over real quick, and I'm going to go figure out any technical difficulties. So I apologize for those. We can get those six right away.
It's all right. I think I can handle this. Number 11 takes a shot there and drains it. Shane Rector controlling the floor right now. Dominant floor. And we've seen one too many of those the past couple of games. You know, it's one thing to pull a cool alley-oop. And it's certainly not a hazard in this game, but you can't make a habit of it, especially if you're not going to convert it very often. Not a smart play there by leadership. South Kent in the in-and-out game. Shane Rector knocks out a three-point there. He was two. Right close. They try to answer back from three of their own, but just barely off. And a kick ball. Play there by Seth Kent. Hard for Shane to control that. Seth Kent again in the full court man press, trying to wear this team down to the grindstone. They're already well ahead, but they don't want to stop, and that's good coaching. As he airs the layup. You can tell right off the bat, even at halftime, that leadership is tired. And that's fine. You know, I've been in this situation plenty of times where not enough players show up, or you know, in some cases, I got to go 4-on-5. It's just brutal, you know. You gotta be a little empathetic on their side. But
they're working hard, and that's what you got to do. There you go. Finally, a shot falls. This time coming from Sean there on the rebel. Shane making a nice pass, but unfortunately, a little late. Three South Kent subs come in: Nolan Long, Kamal Richards, and AJ Edwards come in. Takes a wide open three, knocks it down, takes advantage of those threes, something very valuable.
Right, and we're all set. Back in business. I didn't even get a chance to go get all the staff at halftime. It was so quick.
It's all right. Good hustle play there.
Ball almost made its way into the booth here. You know, I'm surprised. We don't have padding in these pipes right here.
Yeah.
You just, you know, just take one thing to mess up someone's day.
Yeah, not a lot of room either. Not a lot of cushion space between the floor and this metal crate.
Metal crate, I like the way you put that. You get the coach yelling, shoot it, shoot it. Yeah. You get the rare shot clock horn here, heard in the building. Get Mr. Moore on the shot clock tonight. And good finish.
Nice layup.
That's one thing Nolan's got to do, is got to be able to finish those. Yeah, he can finish the rim. The little short, little hooks there. That's what, those are the ones he has to cash in on to be effective at the next level.
That's true. He stumbled that one. I think he was expecting that pass there.
It looked like Kamal, he had three options there. He didn't know which one to throw it to.
But you got to be ready, you know.
Right.
Even if you don't think you're an option, you still got to be ready.
Right. Pick up the foul there.
But as a passer, you have to acknowledge that the other person is ready as well.
Call the guy's name out, maybe.
Yeah.
And not to give it away, but say, hey, I'm actually throwing it to you, not the other guy.
Yeah, I had a coach, my last coach, Coach Benz, last 3 years, said, even if a guy is wide open, he never passes the ball unless his hands are out and looking to catch the ball.
Miles picking up that hit, what is at least his second foul.
Shane Rector will go to the line for two.
Well, we got a chance to have a lot of guys in double figures tonight.
Yep.
We got Zach Brown's got 10. Kamal Richards got 10. Reggie Abeko's got at least 8. AJ's got at least 11. So we got three guys there already. Reggie could get there. And Shane could get there too. Yeah, RJ Taylor's gonna come in and get some more time. It's definitely don't want Shane going down.
Yeah, it's good to give Shane some rest and RJ some playing time.
Yeah, definitely. He's, you know, I think he might be playing the rest of the second half.
Yes, and passed him coming out of the locker room there and he definitely seemed determined. There's some love next to him. Next time, a nice shot.
Paul's got one of the best jump shots I've seen.
Yeah, it's really nice. Takes the long three. And what I've noticed about at least the South Kent starting five is that pretty much all of them take the ball up.
Yeah.
You know? And that's kind of a cool thing to have.
Unique. It's unique.
Yeah.
If not often do you see it. What's up? Not often do you have a how tall is Reggie? 6'8" who can control a basketball.
Yeah.
Or 6'8" like Kobe, but Reggie's not Kobe.
Well, yes, they're not professionals yet.
Right.
You know, Kevin Durant's like 6'11".
Right. He
can control the ball, like, you know.
You like figure tall guys for this league, 6'8", 6'9" are centers in this league, and they can control basketball.
Yeah, and that's valuable.
Yeah. What would be like power forwards at maybe college or the NBA?
Yeah, and that's the thing is that high school is, you know, it's fun, but college is a totally different story.
Different monster, yeah.
So you could just, you know, rock it in high school, but then once you get to college, you really got to work.
Yeah.
You know, even decent.
This, like, be high, this level times at least 10, 20.
Which comes to a shock is a lot of players, and, you know, they think they're ready coming out of high school, and they're just not.
Like, even at the Division III level, the Nova Western, Elm High School Western New England, they had a decent team. They were great, but great move there by Richards. And he's got 16, 18 points.
And they just leave 24 wide open. It seems to make a difference. Rob wanted the assist.
He didn't have the points.
That's an important thing to know as well, is that scoring is everything, you know. You got to assist. And RJ's really kind of found his niche in assisting, which is good for him because beating a team is more important than, you know, scoring yourself.
Malik Miles with a nice move. You know, at the next level, if RJ gets there, I hope he will. Point guard, you got to be the assist man.
Yeah, you gotta lead a team.
Facilitate the offense.
You gotta have trust in your team. You gotta show that you have trust in your team. So it's much more than just dribbling a ball. You gotta really bring your team together and give them some confidence.
Right, and that's what your coach, Coach Morris, that's what he emphasized to Keenan Williams today in practice.
Yeah. Yes, my favorite Keenan for the past 2 years. He's just gotten better. You know, he's really quite a floor general now. It's quite impressive.
And it doesn't matter who you are, as long as you keep emphasizing that to your players.
Yeah.
Like, you are the leader. You are the leader. Like, you think Chris Paul needs to be told that he's a leader on the floor? He knows that. But the coach has to reinforce it. I use Chris Paul as probably the ultimate example. That's going to be Steph's. It's a bit of a track meet now. Might see triple digits tonight. 76 points right now. We got about 11.
Well, if we see triple digits, that'll be
two games in a row.
Few, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. One of the few games I've seen here. Well, into triple digits.
And his last game was a loss to Notre Dame, 108-106 in overtime.
Right, that was quite an exciting game to watch. A good show by both teams.
Definitely.
They both really tried to just come up 2 points short. That's frustrating.
You know, South Kent was a... Come on, Hicks. He's got like 18. And Walters fell. South Kent was down by double digits in the second half of that game. They came back to tie it up. They had a lead at one point.
Yeah. A small bit of a lead, and Notre Dame came back. tight game like that, you got to play just as hard on defense as you do on offense, if not harder.
The leadership is finding it hard to get anything to fall right now, and that ball miraculously goes back to the Browns' hands. Miles finishes. And if I find leadership right now, leadership's got to be gassed by now.
Yeah. Yeah, it's difficult to not have any bench.
Yeah. You got to give it up to the guys. They're still playing hard. They were still doing a one-man press. You had your pressing with six guys with no gas.
Yeah. Yeah, pressing is hard for any team, even if you have as deep a bench as you want. Good rebound by Craig Davis and putback.
Coach Jefferson, I told my guys, we're still playing the game.
Yeah.
You gotta play defense.
Yes, definitely. RJ gets blocked. As you said, we're still playing the game. You know, there's no quit on defense, and that's Seth Kent is doing that right now.
And so they're just fooling around underneath the hoop and. 3 seconds when they called. And look, I can see Coach Jefferson right now doesn't look very happy. Even though his team is going to cruise to a victory here, he just still doesn't look happy, and I don't blame him.
And that's what a coach looks for is hustle all the time. It's hard hustle, and no matter how much you're up by, if you just stand up there on the court, that doesn't look good to me.
No. Like, you're like this right now. That's inexcusable.
Yeah.
Absolutely inexcusable as Tyson finishes at the rim. And now I bet you Coach Kelvin is going to lay into his team right now.
Especially since the leadership has got almost as many points in the first just a couple of minutes of this half as they did the entire first half.
And you said in the first half, you got to stay focused.
Yeah.
Like, run your sets. And to show no disrespect to leadership, like, run it like a practice. Run your sets.
Yeah. You got to keep playing, and it's good to keep running plays because then it just gets quicker and more crisp, and therefore more accurate and effective. You play like you practice. That's very true, and I hope this is not really practice.
I wouldn't think so. Not with I think Coach Kelvin Jefferson runs a pretty tight ship. So it on both sides, for leadership, keep trying. I know you're tired, but keep pushing. South Kent, it's a blowout, but it's still a basketball game.
Yeah.
Treat it like one. Don't treat it as a joke. Good ball movement there. AJ Edwards picks up his, what I believe to be his 15th point of the night. Bucket there.
Leadership staying outside. Saving some energy.
Nice hit there by Charles Reese. Four tonight.
It was a good try, but he was ready for that pass. So you gotta be ready for that.
Yeah.
Almost reached there.
Good look by RJ, the open man. AJ. Knocked down.
Right now.
AD's got 18. Jamal Richards has 18 as well. Brown has 12. Leadership now. We have 87-44 is our score. We have 7:27 to go in the game. And what looks to be South Kent victory. Which will give them to make it two out of the last three.
Good rebound by Zach. Got to finish that though.
Finish it the first time, yeah. 14 for him. Those was what I'm assuming will be a relatively easy win. A win is a win. I'm gonna knock on wood right now.
Yeah, well, you'll take the W in any form you can take.
You play who's on your schedule, right?
Deep three, good rebound. And, didn't really touch him, but jumping that high.
Might have scraped his back a little bit.
It's kind of some bait for the ref.
Right,
know?
Right.
It's kind of difficult to explain.
Ref sees it.
Yeah, and they're down, so he's gonna call that.
Maybe in a tighter game with less than 5 minutes left, you don't call that. Let him play.
Yeah.
It's interesting, just kind of as he has Miles as a free throw. Interesting to see what goes through the mind of a referee during the game.
Yes, I've often thought that myself. both the good and the bad.
Right. I started doing some like lower level games, fifth and sixth grade games, and you got to make sure you're in position. Because even though it's a very slow pace as to what we're seeing here, if you're refereeing for the first time. And you're not in position, you're like, oh shoot, I'm not in position.
Yeah.
I made a bad call.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and it is very pressuring, especially in a high pressure game.
Yeah.
Because especially if you've got a big crowd, a loud home crowd, they're not going to like any call you take against them.
Right.
And you kind of got to block that out and really just focus on what you need to call.
AJ Edwards now has 21 points. As White takes a timeout leadership. I'm thinking to myself after the game, I can't believe I yell at my... I'm picturing me like a referee out there right now, one of these three. And I'm looking at one of them possibly being myself. I'm like, I can't believe I yell at myself like that during a game.
Yeah.
So when I'm at one of my brother's games now, and I try to tone it down. I'm like, it's a hard job.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, being a ref would be difficult, as a player and as a bystander, it's two totally different perspectives.
Yeah, definitely.
Of course, as a player, you're biased, but you do understand that when, if they call against you, you got to kind of ration out the calls, well, what did they call against me that maybe, really didn't happen.
Right, and then if you need to make what we call a makeup call,
yeah.
Like, all right, where can I make the makeup call? Where's a 50-50 ball that can go either way that can give?
Yeah, so...
It's a gray area. It's really a hard job.
Yeah.
And I give them credit. Have you ever done any refereeing?
Nothing more than, Parks and Recreation.
Yeah.
Just some easy stuff. I've never done any high-speed things like this. That would be... I honestly don't think I could be very good at it. No, I don't know the place, but I feel like I'd be too caught up in the game. I would I think I'd miss some.
Yeah.
Zach puts it down.
We get a little highlight reel material there, which I'm sure we'll be highlighting on the website tonight.
Good pass there. Good court vision. It's a nice strip by Zach. He should have just passed that one out. Here comes the dunk, I'm sure.
Kind of.
Yeah. Hey, if I was 6'6", I'd be dunking it down, for no reason.
If I was 6'6", I might have been able to play in college. But I've been 5'7 for... Ooh. Good hit there by Reese. He's got... Double digits now for Reese. And I might have been, maybe I'd be flirting with playing college ball, but 6'6 is a lot different than 5'7, which I've been stuck at since my sophomore year here at South Kent.
Yeah, even I, you know, my father's 6'4", and I'm only 6 foot. You know, I'm kind of like, when are we gonna grow?
Right?
Come on.
Doctor says my growth plates won't stop until I'm 25. I'm like, all right, I got 3 more years. Yeah. We get 100? Yes, we do. Reggie's got 10. We got another Cardinal in double digits. And leadership looks just to start hucking it up. And that's just
good hustle play, though, down low. Yeah, they're getting tired there. Only 3 minutes left in the game.
Can we get a running clock? Oh, battery.
Good rebound by Reggie there. I don't know how many he's got in the game, but it seems like a lot to me. He's quite the fierce big man there. Not sure about that call. It looked hard, but as a player myself, backing down other players, that there's a lot of chance for flopping there. You know?
Yeah. So, given the state of the game.
Yeah, and they're gonna try to get whatever they want. You know, so
right.
You can't blame it at all. But the ball goes right through his legs.
Well, it looks like Coach Jefferson wants to chuck him. He can certainly get up.
Yeah, yes he can.
Zach Brown's now got 20.
Young too.
Yeah, definitely.
So he's got a lot of potential there. He's nice rolling.
One of them hits over Reggie, hard to do. Hey, you're a senior, right, Richie?
Yes, I am.
You are looking into colleges yet?
Yeah. I've applied to UConn,
yep.
To Lynn down in Florida. But,
I heard that was a good school down there.
Oh yeah, it's beautiful.
You gone for a visit?
Yeah, I did actually. I did last year, and my folks got a small condo down there, so
nice.
I know the area. And yeah, it's really pretty. I'm really thinking of going there. You know, as legendary of a ball player I am, I think I'm gonna try to go into radio. You know?
Man, you certainly got a voice for it. You did a great job tonight.
Yes. Face for radio.
I did a radio and play-by-play at where I went to school, and I had a fun with it. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun. Yeah, and it's important. I think because there's just no defense on AJ.
That's his 4-3 of the night.
You know,
he's got 28. AJ Edwards looking for 30. Possibly the next possession. We got 106 to 52 with just under a minute now to go in the game. And Reggie's locked there. AJ wants 30.
There's the pass.
But Reggie says, I want that dunk. Oh, we'll get one more shot. Let's try to get AJ 30 minutes right here. Let's see what we can do. RJ's looking to run the offense. Greg David, yeah, he's running the offense like we said. I think AJ knows he's got 28 right now. Yeah, the fans are taking my ISO.
There's Mr. Taylor out there cheering his son up.
Oh, RJ.
I really missed that. I know he wanted that.
in what turned out to be a kind of a laugher.
Yeah.
That's a, you know, definitely not kind of, it was a laugher. Finals, what's that?
To work on, you know, this is a good game to work on your set plays and things like that.
But know that this was by no means what to expect Sunday against Bridgeton.
Very true.
Final score 108 for South Kent, leadership prep 52. I'm Anthony Camardi with Richard O'Shaughnessy. Give thanks to Brian Farrell, Ren Shu, and Jinwei. We'll be back Sunday with the game against Bridgeton Academy at 3 o'clock. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you later.